as late as the 20th century in Europe, the human excrement had to be removed physically. It had to be removed from the cesspits and the privies in Europe. So the people had to remove it, and the toilet waste from the houses used to be collected in the cesspits. And the European lower caste people, who did the dirty job of collecting it, they were called gong farmers in French, or gong farmers in English. Mm-hmm. And they were allowed to only work at night. So in the dead of the night, they had to go into respectable neighborhoods and collect all that excrement. They would have carts with them, and they would put it in the carts, and they would cart it away to the outside the city limits. They were not allowed to live in the main part of the city. And in fact, there were penalties. There were fines if they were seen during the daytime. These lower caste gong farmers in Europe who were tasked with removing the excrement. Right. So this is how they were called also night soil people. So they were, because they were only seen during night. Now, for some reason, the impression has been created that only in India, we have a lower caste that does all the dirty work. But in reality, all over the world, people who engaged in occupations like removing the waste or garbage, they always belong to the lowest rungs of society. And they were kind of ostracized, and they were not given the same respect by the elites. Obviously, no one would like to do this work by choice. Only when modern technologies came on the scene, technologies to inspect sewers, clean manholes, all the gear that people wear, if they have to get into manholes, the protective gear, and then the oxygen masks. Only when all that came, then a degree of respectability was given to people who did the job. So that's how it evolved in Europe.